listen, Bonnie, you and I both know there are thousands of businesses and corporations that can continue to exist, but none of the huge Fortune 500, none of the big transnational corporations would even be allowed to exist according to the rules and regulations that had been put into place during the founding of this country, and that was true for over 100 years. Now, my friends, I am not suggesting that 1789 was the land of milk and honey. We already covered this. Slavery existed. Women were being systematically oppressed. Still are, but not to the same level that they were. That working class men were being oppressed. The point I'm making is not that this was perfect, but what I'm saying is the instrument, the tool known as the corporation, was appropriately and politically controlled. That's all I'm saying, right? So I like to say this. You know, I'm from Texas, so y'all heard this. Don't throw the baby out with the bathwater. Right?
In the Middle Ages.
The point I'm making here is that the idea of properly controlling the corporation is a good idea, right? Slavery and genocide are bad ideas, right? So we could actually appropriately use the political process to actually control our society. That's all I'm getting at. And now that we know that it takes an action of state government to create the corporate charter, we know that the corporate charter can be used to hold the corporation subordinate and accountable. We understand that the corporate charter describes the duties of what a corporation can or cannot do. We understand that the corporate charter should only be allowed to exist if it serves the public interest. Isn't it just as obvious as it could be that a corporation should be here so that it can be properly politically controlled? And now, my friends, thank you for your patience, because here comes the punchline of it all. When the U.S. Supreme Court comes waltzing in, and five of them tell 300 million of us, oh no, from now on you've got to treat a corporation like it's a person with rights, you pervert the whole thing.
Yeah.
See, corporate personhood is a shorthand for the legal doctrine illegitimately created by the court that says a corporation must be treated as if it's a person with constitutional rights. What that means, in effect, is that corporate lawyers can go into court and overturn any democratically enacted law. It means corporate lawyers can argue, and frequently do, overturn worker safety laws. It means corporate lawyers can argue, and frequently do, overturn environmental protection laws. It means corporate lawyers can go in and overturn, and they frequently do, public health and public safety laws. And, of course, in Citizens United, it means that corporate lawyers can go in and overturn campaign finance laws. They don't even let us protect the integrity of our own electoral process. And that's why Move to Amend is calling for a constitutional amendment. You're going to blow up that. Take the power out of the hands of the court. They never had to begin with. Because I want to be clear about this, friends. The court illegitimately, immorally created this idea that a corporation has constitutional rights. But the court also illegitimately, immorally created the idea that money equals political speech. And that's why the Move to Amend campaign is calling unequivocally for the abolition of both of those doctrines, right? And we are not going to compromise. And I know that there are many good groups at the national level that are trying to compromise and say, well, let's just get money out of elections and don't deal with corporate personhood. And we say, again, pipeline worker, local number 38, also a trial lawyer, let me tell you something. When it comes to negotiating, you do not compromise before the fight really begins. Right? We are on the cusp at the beginning part of an actual movement that could transform this society. The ruling elite are already trying to figure out the end game. Well, I got news for them. You know what the end game is? We're going to restructure society. That's the end
game. Amen.
Right? We have to. And you know what? It ain't nothing personal. And I'm not even joking, right? Because these wealthy elite who are making all the decisions that are destroying the planet, I actually don't think they're evildoers. I think they're mentally ill.
Yes.
Right? I mean that sincerely, right? I mean that with compassion. Seriously, stay with me. I'm not making a joke. I think they're mentally ill because they actually think that they're, doing good somehow. Like, and that they're justified in it. Right? Yeah, and here's the thing. If we had a just... Hold on, Leslie's up. Let me finish up. If we had a just and compassionate society, we would get them help. Right? Instead, we put them in charge, and that really is our fault. So we got to actually start changing things. So here's the thing. If you like what you're hearing, I'm going to give you the opportunity to join Move to Amend. And I want to be clear about something. Move to, like many of you, I recognize a couple of faces in the crowd. This is basically what I've been talking about for 15, 20 years, right? So this is not new, but what is new is a movement called Move to Amend. Move to Amend was only created in 2010, right? Today, we just clicked over 316,000 people. And we have 160 local affiliates, and I think that we've got one here locally, so we want to get you involved in the local organizing effort. And we've helped 500 communities pass resolutions in support. And we've helped 16 states pass resolutions. And we've put this issue on the ballot in 28 jurisdictions.
Hoorah!
We've won every single one of them. Wow. including conservative areas like rural Ohio and Utah and the entire state of Montana. Anybody want to make the argument that Montana is some sort of liberal lefty bastard? I didn't think so. Point is, everywhere that we've taken this, we've won. Because I'm going to bring you back. We're going to open up for discussion. I'm going to pass this around. But before I do, I want to remind you, in the beginning of this, I challenged you to challenge me. Is this a story that only liberals and lefties can hear and appreciate and understand?
No.
Or does this story transcend that kind of...
Exactly.
Because
Here's
the thing, friends. I've given this presentation, as I've told you, at Occupy encampments and at Unitarian churches and in union halls across this country. And everywhere I go in those places, I get laughter and I get applause, just like I got from you. You know what else? It's not as often, but I will tell you. I've given this presentation at the John Birch Society, and I've given it at the Tea Party groupings. And you know what? I got laughter and I got applause. Now, I'll admit the laughter and applause came at totally different places. But it came, right? For example, limited government, sovereignty, you know, the authority of we the people, the founders, these are things that really resonate. Now, I'll be honest, I have a different accent, right? I'm not disingenuous. But there is a way to tell the story about how our democratic republic is supposed to operate in a way that I think that almost all Americans, except the 1%, can actually understand. Now, there's going to still be disagreement on policies, right, on public policy, and we should be okay with disagreeing on public policy. And honestly, when it comes election time, like, we're going to actually have fierce disagreements. But when it comes to how our constitutional framework is supposed to operate, that's actually something that I think that there's a lot of common ground. Polling data demonstrates it. Because I want to be clear. Corporate personhood steals our sacred right to self-government. And as a lawyer, what really chaps my hide, they're using the legal system to legitimize the theft. Mm-hmm. And I say it's time for us to do what other movements have done. Say, ya basta, enough already. We're going to rise up in a nonviolent revolution and assert our sovereign rights. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to start here and give you a pen. If you would like to join this group, if you want to start one in the back with me.
I'm going to ask you to take this camera.
I'm going to start this. Say, keep this one on this side, this one on this one. If you want to join this movement, I will ask only this. Print legibly. That's all. And listen, if you don't want to join, that's cool, just pass it. I won't be offended. I think I'll be surprised, but I won't be offended. But if you are going to sign, really take your time to print legibly. Now, what I'm going to do is open it up for discussion, questions, comments, and I mean it. If you just want to make a comment, that's fine. Anybody who wants to make a comment or ask a question, raise your hand. So, number one, hold on, number one. Who else? Number two, number three. Sir, you'll be number four. Sir, you'll be number five. Number six, thank you so much. Number six, I think you're already on, aren't you? Ramsey, you'll be number seven. Good to see you again. Number seven, Ramsey, an old friend from back in the day. So we got those seven. So remember your numbers, because my trick only works if you remember your number.
You are number two.
Yeah, you are. All right, so remember it. But before we go on to this, I got to ask, Octavia, what did I charge you to come here today?
Nada.
Nothing. Kim?
Nothing.
Bonnie, what was the fee? Zero. It's my standard fee. But I'll tell you something, friends, I still like to eat. So, you know, Ramsey, I see you got a hat. Can I borrow that hat for a minute? No? You don't want it? Can I borrow somebody else's hat? Do you want that hat?
Not many hats, are there?
No, that's all right. I know, right? Your hat is like, it's a pretty nice hat. Can I borrow your hat, Ryan? Thank you so much. I'm gonna start. One hat on one side, good to see you, Jacob. One side on another, and I'm gonna pass the hat, right? And, yes, right, that's all I do. And let me be clear, folks, do not leave just because I'm passing a little old hat around, right? If you don't wanna put any money on it, don't. As my grandfather, the Baptist preacher, would say, this is a free will gift. I gave a gift to you of this information. You can give a gift or not as you like. If you would like to make a credit card donation, though, Ruthie, would you wave your hand?
Yes.
This is Ruthie. We have one of these fancy things. If anybody...